up in practice gave Jack pole position on the grid. He kept in front right from the start, number five.
Jack Brabham and his own Repco Brabham.
Yeah, I mean, what an incredible moment in history. You know, my father winning his third world championship in a Brabham, as you say, the first time ever anyone's done that with his own construction. The combination of the Repco engine V8 and the Goodyear tyres, they made history. It's so significant in Formula One. That whole combination was just a step ahead of everybody else. In fact, the tyres are probably the most important part of the car. At times, he would lap the whole field. That's how dominant they were.
Into the lead, Jack Brabham in frightful weather conditions. Brabham wins his fourth title race in a row at an average of over 86. It's also the first time that a driver has ever won a world title event in a car of his own construction.
'66 was a momentous year in motorsport. I have to say, I think of '66 as the year that my dad won Indianapolis, but it is also the year that Jack won in his own car, and he won it on Goodyears as well. So it's an achievement which I don't think will ever be repeated. I haven't driven one of David's cars yet, because he's very, very careful about letting people drive his cars, and I don't think he trusts me completely.
Did you get that? Because I ain't repeating it, you know that, don't you?
So at what stage did Goodyear get involved with the BT62?
Well, when we launched the BT62, we launched it as the ultimate track car. If you look back at the incredible history that Brabham has had in Formula One, I kind of felt like it's my duty. And then, all of a sudden, we thought, right, you know, we need to go racing. So we approached Goodyear, and we went and did a test, and we tried their F1 SuperSport tyres, and it was just the perfect match. The balance between the car and the tyre and the driver was exactly what we needed. We went to Brands Hatch, and we won. Goodyear's history, its DNA, our relationship in the past, the technology that's available. You've got this incredible legacy, but what's next? How do we take that forward? And that's what we've been working on in the background and what we launched not that long ago.
So David, what's next for Brabham Automotive and Goodyear?
Well, do you want to come and have a look? Yeah, this is our ultimate track car for the road, the BT62R. When we were approached about doing a road version of the track car, we spoke to Goodyear about their SuperSport RS. So it was a perfect combination to give the same dynamic performance from what we take on the track onto the road.
And do you think Sir Jack would be proud of what you've achieved?
It's a shame that he wasn't around to see this come to life, but I'm pretty sure he'd be pretty happy. The partnership between Goodyear and Brabham Automotive for our cars on the track and the road is extremely important. You know, we pride ourselves on being the most dynamic cars in the world. You can't do that unless you've got the right tyre. So that partnership is very critical for us.
You've got to understand the extremes of these cars. You know, it's an ultra high performance sports car. And the SuperSport RS is aimed at the real enthusiast that's using these cars at the track at the limit. The difference is that this is a tyre that you can drive home on afterwards.
The relationship between Goodyear and my father and the Brabham team was very much part of the ingredients of making this car, the BT62R. To get the name back out there and where it is today with what we're doing, you know, means a lot to me and my family.
He's not too old at 40 by this superbly confident win.